it's really just an idea. That's all it is. And people subscribe. And that's why it's become what it's become.
We have doctors that are walking away from their practices, firefighters that are walking away from their stations, volunteering weeks of their life every year.
It was everything that I'd always wanted, doing something directly to help people that really need it.
In 24 hours, we showed up at LAX with 30 duffel bags full of medical supplies. We were off to Chile.
You put goodwill out there, it's amazing what can be accomplished.
We just pulled into a camp, setting up some water filters because they don't have water, and people are lining up.
We're here in Tuscaloosa in our first neighborhood. A house here, we requested some help.
The second we hit, we want to be as effective as possible because we don't know what to expect.
People are getting sick from the water here.
We have lacerations that are infected right now.
We're all packed up, loaded, food and water enough for at least 3 days.
We're set up in a church. All of a sudden, we got an influx of patients.
Gail went to work. She set up a table out of a door.
We don't know what we're getting into all the time. We didn't know we were going to get a helicopter to take us into an orphanage and work there for 3 days. We didn't know we were going to set up a medical clinic on a debris pile.
So far, we've seen 17 patients today.
Two international plane flights with almost 50 bags of medical gear is a testament to the power of prayer and to the power of what a volunteer's heart can accomplish.
I've looked fathers in the eyes, you know, that are holding their kids and they're begging for help, and I can imagine how that feels. They're desperate and they're looking to a stranger and pleading for help, and it's hard to talk about, but it's stuff like that that just, it gets you.